and welcome to In All Things. In this episode, I'll be speaking to some more Catholic youth, actually two sisters, all about making a difference. I've invited Raisa and Renee Jose from Vancouver, BC to come speak with us today and share their experiences of making a difference in their community. I know they'll have no shortage of things to share, as together they've co-founded a nonprofit organization, The Giving Truck, that mobilizes other youth to get out there and serve those in need. And so without further ado, let's go. So Raisa and Renee, hello, welcome to the show.
Hi, so happy to be here.
No, very happy to have you both. And just to clarify for our viewers, for our audience, who is Raisa and who is Renee?
So hello, my name is Renee Jose, and I am Raisa's little sister.
And I'm Raisa, I'm Renee's older sister.
Oh, perfect, perfect. Thanks. So Raisa and Renee, you know, I'm very excited to talk about your nonprofit organization. I find the story very inspirational. So just to start off and to dive right in, how is it that your organization, The Giving Truck, which is actually a truck, it's a physical truck as well, how is it that your organization, The Giving Truck, started and what inspired it?
Yeah, so just as you said, The Giving Truck is an actual truck, and we happen to own a 12-passenger van that we use for our family outings, and we have a very big family, so we're always using it for ice cream trips, road trips, and our family is just very close. Like, we all grew up volunteering through performing and directing fundraising musicals, singing in our church choir, doing meal programs together, singing in nursing homes, and the list goes on. But my sister and I actually wanted to share this passion for service with more people our age. And since the youth can't drive to, let's say, the downtown east side to distribute care kits, for example, we realized that there was a better use for our family van. And we were able to get volunteers, as many volunteers as possible, to join us in each volunteer activity. So we're able to transport both our volunteers and our donations to our events. And the mission of The Giving Truck is to get the youth out there to do random acts of kindness and spread love. And we do this by having a different volunteer activity each month.
Beautiful. And I believe it got kickstarted off the ground also from a school initiative too that inspired you.
Mm-hmm. It was in that leadership class where we were tasked with creating a legacy project, and that typically was like an awareness week, but I decided to create this nonprofit organization, the first of its kind, and it was really from that leadership class where I had that push and the support of the school, my classmates, and especially my family.
You know, you've mentioned so many different things that you were inspired from, and I have to say that I can definitely see that in what you guys are doing on your social media. I was looking through all the things that you guys are doing, and it's quite a lot in the best of ways. Can you guys go over all the initiatives that you guys are a part of, all the things you guys are doing with the organization?
Yeah, sure. So as you mentioned, we have different events each month, and they vary from meal programs in a men's shelter, shoreline cleanups, which we did last summer actually, making sandwiches, doing a clothing drive for those of the downtown east side. The downtown east side is an area highly populated by those experiencing homelessness, so we were able to have a clothing drive there. We celebrated Valentine's Day at a nursing home, singing love songs and giving out chocolates. And also on Mother's Day, we did a spa day for women who are overcoming poverty, homelessness, and addiction. And so those are just our projects that we've been doing each month, just like a gist of everything together.
If I can add on to Renee, our aim with this is to be the bridge between the big organizations and the youth. So being able to see the youth of today really enjoy the service that they're doing, it makes us realize at the end of the day, our service is worth it.
So speaking of youth and speaking of being youth in general,
How, you know, what you guys are doing is really big, and I think it's quite a large initiative. You know, co-founding a nonprofit. Did you guys ever experience any challenges related to doing this, and how are you able to overcome it?
Yeah, for sure. I can start personally, balancing my time with the Giving Truck while also taking courses and working. I really didn't think it would be possible at first, but because it was something that I loved and something that I was so passionate about, it made my first year at university so much more memorable. And it was actually kind of perfect how the courses I took coincided with my work and with the Giving Truck. When I took a business course on organizational behavior, that really helped me learn skills that I can incorporate with the Giving Truck. And moreover, with work, I could deal with donors and alumni of the school, and I was given unique opportunities to network with influential individuals such as CEOs, founders, directors of multiple organizations, and learn directly from them. So everything pretty much worked harmoniously and truly shaped what the Giving Truck is today. And Renee and I were continuing to learn more things as we go, because nobody really teaches you how to run an organization, but the logistics of everything has had its ups and downs for sure.
Yeah, I think to add on to that, like as my sister mentioned, again, nobody teaches us how to run an organization, with me being only 15 right now. So sometimes when we do like our fundraising or coordinating with volunteers, contacting other organizations, organizing donations, it can be really tiring, and it can be, to be honest, very tedious, and it's an exhausting job for sure, especially because we're still teenagers. Oh, my sister's 20, but we're still pretty young. So as you mentioned, we're still youth and there's a lot to learn still. But something we work on is looking at the bigger picture of things. Right now, it may seem super exhausting, or at the end of the day, we feel unmotivated, but sometimes we just have to realize that we are constantly motivated with positivity. There's so many youth volunteers who are so eager to help us out. So at the end of the day, my sister and I are always knowing we're not doing this alone. We have so much support from our friends and our big family. And I guess knowing that we have the chance to change someone's perspective on something, even just for a day, can just keep us motivated to go through all these challenges. So definitely we've had our ups and downs for sure.
Co-founding an organization and starting an organization, running it with all the things you guys are doing. You know, as Catholic youth, there must have been an element of prayer and faith involved in what you guys have done and are doing too. So how was prayer and faith a part of it? And how have your individual faith lives changed and grown since starting the Giving Truck?
We are two very simple girls rooted in our faith. I think every event before we leave, my family always does a prayer on the truck on the way there. So our parents always remind us to pray for conversion. So whether it be for a volunteer, for us, or for the people we're helping, it doesn't mean like a big, huge realization for someone, but it's just a way to step back and say, hey, maybe I can make someone smile today, or maybe they can say, that was a great meal that I just received. So something like that. And after each event, when we get back home, we always say a prayer of thanksgiving, just to thank God for the amazing things that have been happening with us. But for me specifically, I think I've definitely grown in my spirituality with the Giving Truck. I'm already a part of a lot of activities in my parish, whether it be singing for the choir in Sunday Mass, or even being a leader at my youth ministries. So my faith has been pretty steady with all these programs, but the Giving Truck always gives me that push or that spark to grow in my faith journey, I believe. The Giving Truck allowed me to see that I'm able to love God by loving others. So I realized that my spiritual pathway is a caregiver, someone who worships God through service. And I feel that's where I am closest to Him, when I'm out there serving others as much as I can. So I believe that's how my faith has really grown with the Giving Truck. And I'm so, so, so thankful.
I totally relate with Renee. I find the most joy when I'm serving others, and nothing can really I can't even put it into words, like that feeling when you literally look someone in the eye and give them a care kit, or you're just spending that time with that person. I really feel that time is the most precious gift you can give someone, and giving that to someone is irreplaceable. Like, you can't really explain it unless you actually experience it. So that's why Renee and I, we want to share this joy of giving to others and invite youth to do the same, because it's really when you have that genuine human interaction, giving someone a meal, giving someone a care kit, giving someone your time, is when you really feel God's presence, for me personally. So
I have found it in my life too, the times when I put myself out there and serve, like, very hands-on and hands-on manners, that like my faith grows so much and everything just becomes very concrete, you know. The gospel just feels like it's being lived right there and then. So I definitely relate to what you guys are saying. Do you guys have a saint or a scripture that you hold onto or you hold dear during your work?
Mm-hmm. As women, we really look up to Saint Mother Teresa and her tremendous service to others. A quote that really sticks out to Renee and I, and what we really believe in with our ministry, is not all of us can do great things, but we can do small things with great love. And being a Catholic organization, it has really helped us to have this foundation. And even at school, we're continuously strengthening our values. We're counting our blessings and constantly reminded of the values of kindness. And another Bible verse that I hold close to my heart is from Matthew 25, verse 40. Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. And this passage is a constant reminder that our mission here on earth is not only showing our love for others, but showing our love for God.
And Renee, I don't know if you have the same saint that you hold dear to or the same scripture. Feel free to add on to that if you like.
Yeah, like as my sister said, like, as sisters, we really look up to Saint Mother Teresa. The amount of work that she did for others, truly giving herself out to others, is something that my sister and I really aspire to do. As you said, we're very rooted in our faith, so constantly using scripture, but also just being able to live out our faith is something that we love doing. It's something that it very hits close to home.
Mother Teresa actually experienced a lot of moments of providence in her ministry, moments of God's hand interceding and providing. And so I'm wondering, on that note, if you guys have also seen or experienced providence in any way with the giving truck.
Yeah, for sure. I can take this one. A lot of opportunities, a lot of the events actually that have come our way really have just come as blessings. Like, we have seen people reach out, people going out of their way, people giving us these positive messages, reassuring us that what we're doing is really making a difference. And it's so nice. Like, I know Renee mentioned this previously, saying how sometimes we feel overwhelmed or we feel like everything that we're doing isn't worth it. But when we see those messages and we see the encouragement from other people, it really lifts us up, and it really makes us feel that what we're doing is, there's a purpose to it. And it's reaching out to people in a way that we may not see with our own eyes. It's really happening within them, and I find that so beautiful. And even just having this opportunity, right, like this came out to speak with you, like, it's such a blessing. And we are just constantly praying, constantly hoping for new opportunities to come our way. And so far, even in the matter of time that we've done the giving track, almost a year and a half now, the ministry has grown to such a beautiful organization that we never thought would be possible today.
I love hearing stories like the ones that you have of youth getting involved in everything. The way that the giving truck works, it's also very reliant, if I'm correct, on donors, sponsors, and volunteers. So have you also seen, you touched upon it a little bit, but have you also seen providence with that too? People coming in at the right time, helping out at the right time?
Great. So the Giving Truck posts these volunteer testimonies on our social media pages and on our website. And this is to really show and demonstrate that volunteering is transformative. It's not just transformative for the people we're helping, but also for the volunteers themselves, because they're able to see that, you know, volunteering is pretty exciting. So when we post these testimonies, we ask the people we're volunteering, like, oh, what was your experience? And we don't even have, sometimes we don't even have to ask. They're like, oh, I really want to talk about this. Like, I loved this. So for example, for one event at the Shoreline Cleanup, I had some of my friends take part in it. They were saying, I didn't know volunteering was this fun. And they were able to share it with their family when they got home. They posted it on their social media and saying, like, check out the Giving Truck. Like, it's such a fun event. Posting all these photos of, you know, having that companionship and having that, having that companionship with everyone. Sometimes you go to these volunteer events and the youth there don't even know each other at first, but at the end of the day, we're making sandwiches together, making meals, we're helping each other at a spa event. So I think just seeing that, just taking a moment to step back, and when I'm taking photos or anything, being able to witness their enthusiasm, as you mentioned, but these volunteer testimonies are definitely a testament to how excited they are and how amazing the youth are. I really commend them for all the work, even us being youth as well, but just stepping back and saying, this is pretty cool. So that's definitely something that we've discovered with our volunteers.
Well, it's very evident that you guys are passionate about the youth, and that you want the youth to make a difference, to get involved. I mean, in fact, your slogan, oh, I don't want to get it wrong, but I believe it was mobilizing youth, driving change. Oh, okay, good. Perfect. your slogan in itself, also shows that you're all about youth. And I'm very curious about that. How is it that you guys are passionate about the youth, and how is it that became a fire in your heart?
Well, I can take this. I believe youth have this drive and the passion to really go and pursue something that they really really believe in. So they are really passionate about social justice. We have clubs at schools, but also going out there to physically be there with the people and doing something about it is something that I find youth have the most joy in. And personally, like with me and my friends, like we love volunteering together, not only to do an activity together, but also helping someone while doing so. And yeah, I don't know if there's anything you'd like to add, Renee.
Like we mentioned before, just being at school and seeing my friends, and they're like, oh my goodness, I found this volunteer opportunity, I want to do it. Even without us saying anything like, oh, we can help you out with that or anything, right? But just seeing them see the youth have that drive, seeing the youth, even some of my friends starting their own organizations, starting their own startups, even doing simple acts or just going out there, making the effort to go online and think of where can I do something in Vancouver, or how can I help with like the local library. I think it's really evident, like everyone has a very good heart, but I think it's definitely evident in the youth today, because we're young, we have all this joy, and you have all this drive to start something. So why, as my sister mentioned, like, why not start now, right? So
absolutely, why not start now? That's a great line. If a youth is watching, one of the youth out there that have this fire in their heart, that have energy, what advice would you have for them? What would you say?
For me, what I would say is that you lose nothing by being kind. The thing I always wanted to reiterate whenever we do our talks is that you don't need to go out there and start your own organization. There's no need to get out of the world and do something super big. No, it really means how much love you can give to the world in the simplest of ways. So that's just something that I would tell you guys, because I think spreading love is just super important. It's said all the time, but it really means a lot when you take it into effect.
Some advice that I would give is there's nothing to lose by trying. We're young. There's no one stopping you. And we hope that, well, Renee and I hope that we can inspire you.
So you guys, you know, you've done a lot already, many initiatives, many beautiful things that you guys have taken on. But what's next for the Giving Truck? What are your hopes and where would you like to go from here?
So currently we're providing a meal program at the Men's Hostel, which is a men's shelter for those experiencing homelessness in the downtown east side here in Vancouver. And what we do is we individually pack these hot meals in a food safe kitchen and deliver it to these men, to our brothers in the downtown east side. And we hope to continue with this. We've been surprised by the amount of opportunities that are coming our way, and we're so blessed with in so many unexpected ways. So we're really using prayers and support to help us and to keep going. And we're going to keep engaging with people our age to go out there and have that mindset of love, of sharing love and sharing kindness.
Yeah. I mean, just like my sister said, we're going to keep going. Like, the journey will, for now, it's not going to stop. We're going to keep spreading kindness as much as we can. And as I mentioned, we're just going to let the Giving Truck journey unfold as God planned it to be. So we're going to keep going. And we're just so blessed. We always say that at the end of the day, we are so, 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 so blessed. So yeah, like my sister said, we're just going to keep engaging with the youth and sharing that mindset of love as much as possible.
And so if somebody's watching and they would like to help you guys out, to support the Giving Truck, what can they do? Where can they go?
So for our activities, we tend to have in-kind donations, meaning materials. So when we go to the men's hostel, let's say we'll need cookies or we'll need baked goods. For other donations, when we're planning our monthly activities, some things need to be taken care of through monetary donations. So those ones can also be directed to us through our email, which is givingtruck@gmail.com. But honestly, yeah, prayers and engagement is really, really helpful, because
yeah,
our organization is fueled by the volunteers and their time and their talents.
Yeah, just absolutely. To add on to that too, with engagement too, just even because I run the social media account for all social media pages, we'll shoot all our contact information, but just following us or sharing it with your friends and family, getting the word out. We love to have more people join us and hop on our Giving Truck with us. We'd love that. So yeah, just share it with your friends and family. We would want to continue our ministry and make this family grow as big as possible. So that's one way you can help us out.
Raisa and Renee, thank you so much for joining me today, for talking to me, for being here on Salt and Light. I have absolutely enjoyed it so much. I've loved what you guys have had to say and share. And I really wish you the best in your work. You can count on my prayers moving forward. And I pray that God continues to bless you so much and just so abundantly.
Thank you so much. That means a lot.
Yeah, I just, on behalf of me and my sister, I just want to say a huge, huge thank you to you for allowing us to share our story and be able to amplify our voice and be able to share what we do and how we can help others as much as we can. So thank you, thank you, thank you so much.
Thanks. And on behalf of all of us, including myself, the youth, everybody, thank you guys for being you and doing what you do too.
Everybody, that is all for today. I hope that you enjoyed the show. If you'd like to rewatch the episode or check out other In All Things episodes, you can do that at saltandlighttv.org. And while you're online, why not find us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter? Thanks so much for watching.